Morning. It's Monday. I've already restarted this because it's Monday, and maybe you're kind of in the same boat. It's Monday, and you're starting out, getting things going, and already it's Monday. So I don't know what you're doing this morning. I don't know if you're at work or if you are home right now, and maybe you've already had to go out or work is already having that day. Maybe you've already encountered some people and maybe it hasn't been as pleasant as you'd like it to. Or maybe you've had an opportunity already today to try to talk to somebody and maybe it didn't go so hot. I hope none of that's true. I hope that you're having a great day, and I hope that if you've already been out and you're talking to people, that you've had an opportunity to try to share the gospel, maybe had a chance to share the gospel, you know, had a chance to really have a great conversation with somebody. But it's also just as likely that we've already been rejected trying to talk to somebody, trying to engage in that conversation and just can't seem to get it migrated and turned that way. Those days are going to happen. It's going to happen more often than not that you're going to try to engage and try to get somebody drawn to a salvation discussion, and they're going to be resistant to it. That's how it is. Listen, Jesus, when he was sending his 12 disciples out, he told them, this is how it's going to be. He said, I didn't come to bring peace. I came to set a sword, to bring a sword against people in judgment. He said, you know, brothers are going to rise up against brothers, and sons against dads, and daughters against mothers, and on he went. He says, it's going to be rough. And in fact, in Matthew 10, 16 through 20, he just told them straight up. He said, behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves. Be ye therefore wise as serpents and harmless as doves. You know, he told us, listen, you're going out into the world. You're going out into a system, a belief system that is antagonistic towards me, that does not want what I have to offer, does not want to hear that they are sinners, does not want to hear that there's a price for that sin. But yet that is exactly what we're here to do. We are here to show people that they are born in sin and that they need a Savior, and that Jesus Christ is indeed that Savior. You know, I've heard many different things about salvation, and, you know, things that preachers and religious groups have taught about, you know, you shouldn't be confrontational in your evangelism. You know, this should be just a lifestyle. You just live your life for Jesus, so people will be crawling on broken glass to get saved. You know, that's not how it works. We have to be confrontational. We have to be willing to engage with people and get to the place where we can tell them, look, you and I, we are born in sin. We are in the same boat here together. We are both born in sin. And if there's not an understanding of why there is a Savior, if they don't know why they need a Savior, they're not going to turn to someone to save them when they don't understand that they need to be saved. Until someone comes into conflict with their own selves, with their own sin, and understands that they are at odds with God, and there's only one cure for this, and his name is Jesus Christ, nothing in their life can or will change. So he says, look, I'm sending you out as sheep amongst the wolves. And he said, it's dangerous. It's going to be ugly. He said, so be wise as serpents. Be prudent. Be calculating in what you do. But be harmless as doves. Yeah, our duty is to tell people about Christ, not to body slam them, not to hold a 40-pound Bible over the head and shove our finger halfway up their nose as we scream at them. It is to introduce them to Jesus Christ and to understand their sin problem. And so he says, you need to be wise as serpents. Find creative ways to have that conversation. Be bold, but be harmless as doves. Don't be underhanded. Don't be subversive, be straight up, be honest, be loving. And he says, and he goes on in the next verse, says, but beware of men, for they will deliver you up to the councils, and they will scourge you in their synagogues, and you should be brought before governors and kings for my sake, for a testimony against them and the Gentiles. He said, listen, this is going to happen. you're not going to always be received. There will be some people who will listen, who will sit down and talk with you and come to understand that they are lost and they need Jesus Christ. They need to trust Christ as their Savior. But there are many who will not do that. And as we go through this life, even in America, and we're seeing the attack on the church right now. We're seeing different states where the pressure, they're using the COVID to try to keep people from going to church. And if you want to go protest and burn stuff down, that's okay, because that's important. But church is not important. There's an attack that's going on the church, and we need to be aware of that. And it's going to get worse. There are people, there are churches who are facing summary judgments. They're facing tickets. They're facing court battles because they are violating some ordinance that says they cannot meet. And I'm grateful that that's not going on in our state right now, but that doesn't say it may not at some point in time. And the closer we get to the return of God, it's going to be like this everywhere. And so we know it's coming. And he said, you know, just beware. Just understand this is how it is. This is what's going to happen. And when they do, he said in verse 19, but when they deliver you up, take no thought of how or what ye shall speak. For it shall be given you in the same hour what ye shall speak. For it is not you that speak, but the Spirit of your Father which speaketh in you. He said, listen, this is going to happen. He said, when it does, don't try to figure out what you're going to say. Don't try to plot ahead of time so much what you're going to say. He said, you will get in that moment, you will get exactly what you need. When you open your mouth to speak in that moment, you don't have to worry about it, because what you say will be what the Father says through you or in you. You will know in the moment. You will know in the very second that you need, you will know what to say. God will give it to you. We can anticipate, we can imagine how things will be, we can imagine how it will go in a confrontation, but we don't really know until we are in that confrontation. And the moment we're in that confrontation, we won't have to worry about it. If we've trusted Christ as our Savior, when we are pressed at the moment, God will give us at that moment exactly what we need to say. How many times, if you have been a soul winner, if you have been out trying to tell people about Christ, how many times have we had a conversation with somebody and something just came to our mind? We have no idea where it came. We walk away after it and say, man, where did that come from? I didn't even know that. I didn't even think about that. I've never even considered it before. But all of a sudden, it was just like I knew exactly what to say. Because you did. You knew exactly what to say. Because it was the Father speaking in you. It was the Spirit of God speaking in you, giving you exactly what you need to say. And it wasn't even a big confrontation. We were just out souling it. We were just telling people, and they were receptive, they were open, but they were asking questions we may not have known at any other time exactly how to answer. But in that moment, all of a sudden we had it. Or in that moment, a verse came to our mind that we would have never considered using. We have our way, we have our plan. Maybe we use the Romans Road, or we use the ABCs of salvation. We have some kind of model that we kind of walk through to keep us on track. And somebody asks a question, or suddenly there's a verse that comes to your mind just out of the blue, and you use that verse, and then you watch them light up and go, oh, I understand it now. And afterwards you think, man, I would have never thought of it. Where did that come from? It came from the Holy Spirit. So don't worry about how the day's going or how the week looks or any situation that we get in. We don't need to worry about it, because no matter what it is, good, bad, or indifferent, a confrontational moment, or maybe somebody asks a question that we're perplexed, don't worry. God will give you what you need in that moment. It works because God is real. This salvation is real. The Holy Spirit of God dwells in us. The moment we say, Jesus, save me, I'm a sinner. The moment we trust Christ as our Savior, that's it right there. You get it. You get the Holy Spirit. And from that point on, when it's crunch time, when that confrontation comes, when that moment of soul winning comes, when that moment to stand before a magistrate or whatever the situation, that moment when it comes, we will have everything we need. We don't have to worry about it. We don't have to plot it out. We don't have to think about it. All we have to do is stand there faithfully and let God do his thing. God is the God of all gods, and his Spirit dwells in us when we have trusted his Son for salvation. So we have everything that we need. We are going out into war. We're going out as sheep amongst wolves, and we don't have to be scared of anything. All we have to do is trust the Father that he will give us what we need in that moment. And we can do that because we trusted his Son for salvation. So have a good day. Have a good week. No matter how things go, no matter how difficult things get, remember, relax. God's got it. And he will give you what you need to say exactly when you need to say it. See you tomorrow morning.